Hi, it's me once again with your math solutions. In this video, we'll be learning how to solve quadratic equations using the completing the squares method. Okay? As usual, like this video, share, and subscribe to my channel. Now let's get back to business. So let's look at this. Given that, okay, let's look at x minus 2 squared, okay? I have x minus 2 squared is equal to, I have x minus 2 bracket x minus 2, and when you use it, you have x squared minus 2x minus 2x plus 4, and it gives us what? X squared minus 4x plus 4. Okay, so you have x minus 2 squared equals x squared minus 4x plus 4. So you can say that this x squared plus 4, you have x squared, minus 4x equals x minus 2 squared, that is x minus 2 squared minus 4. And this is the same thing as saying x minus 2 squared minus 2 squared. So let's try completing the square for this. That x squared plus 2x. Okay? Very easy. Actually, what you do is you find the coefficients of, you divide the coefficients of x by 2 and square it. Okay? So you have x squared plus 2x, and the coefficient of 2 is 1, 1 squared is 1 plus 1. Okay, so you find out that what you have is x plus 1, x plus 1. That's the square, that's what you completed this to. So because x plus, you have x squared plus x plus x plus 1, which gives us x squared plus 2x plus 1. So when you want to complete this to a square, this is what you get, and this is what is square. You have x plus 1 and x plus 1. Okay, let's try another example. Completing this square, you have x squared minus 3x. So like I said, what you do is to divide the coefficients of x by 2 and square it. Okay? So you have x squared minus 3x plus, minus 3 over 2 squared. Okay? So you have x squared minus 3x plus 9 over 4. So you find out that the square or the individual term is x minus 3 over 2 by x minus 3 over 2. Okay, so let's try expanding it. You have x squared minus 3 over 2x minus 3 over 2x, 2x plus 9 over 4. So you have x squared minus 3x minus 3 over 2x minus 3 over 2x gives you minus 3x plus 9 over 4. Okay, so it means that if you add 9 over 4 to this, you get a square. That's just what it means, actually. So let's try using this concept to solve a quadratic equation. So let's look at this. You have x squared minus 2x minus 1 equals 0. Okay? So now you have x squared minus 2x. You move this one over to the other side, equals 1. Okay? Now you try to complete this, make this a complete square. And whatever I add here, you have to add something here to make it a complete square. Whatever I add here, you add it here as well. Okay? So you have x squared minus 2x equals 1. So what do you add here? Complete this, make it a complete square. And whatever you add to this to make it a complete square, you add it to this side to make it to balance the equation, okay? So you have here, you have x squared minus 2x. Divide this by 2 and square it, you have plus 1. When you divide minus 2 by 2, you get minus 1. And when you square it, you have 1. Okay? So you add this one here and you add 1 here as well. Okay? Now when you do that, when you factorize x squared minus 2x plus 1, you have x minus 1 squared. Okay? And what x minus 1 squared gives us, x squared minus 2x plus 1 equals 2. Okay? So, you find the square root of both sides. So, you have x minus 1 equals plus or minus square root of 2. Okay? Because you know that plus 2 times plus root 2 times plus root 2 gives us 2. And minus root 2 times minus root 2 gives us 2. Okay? So you now have our x to be equal to 1 plus or minus root 2. So you have 1 plus or minus 1.414. So you have x to be equal to 1 plus 1.414 is 2.414. Or 1 minus 1.414 equals 0 minus 0.414. Okay, so when x equals this or this, then this equation will be satisfied. Okay, this condition will be met, or this expression will be equal to 0. Let's look at solving this. We have 2x squared minus 3x minus 1. Let's try solving it using completing the squares method. Please note that when we consider using completing the squares method, when it's not easy to factorize it ordinarily, okay? The initial method that we showed in the previous video. If that is not possible, then we'll try using the completing the squares method. So you have 2x squared minus 3x minus 1 equals 0. So let's see, you have 2x squared minus 3x equals, okay, 1. Now, first of all, completing the squares method works when the coefficient of x squared is 1. So we have to divide all round, all through by 2 to get this to be 1. And when we do that, we have x squared minus 3 over 2x equals 1 over 2. Okay, now trying to complete this square, we'll add something here, then we'll add it to this side as well. I'm trying to do it here. You have x squared minus 3 over 2x. Remember, divide this by 2 and square it. When you divide this by 2, you have minus 3 over 4, and when you square it, you have plus 9 over 16 equals 1 over 2 plus 9 over 16. We're adding the terms, the constant to both sides to balance the equation, okay? So that nobody feels cheated. So now let's factorize this. Now have x minus 3 over 4 squared. Okay, when you square this, you get this equals 1 over 2 plus 16, half 16, 8, 16 divided by this is 8, 8 times 1, 8 plus 9 gives us 17. You have 17 over 16. So you find the square root of both sides, okay? We are trying to find our x. So finding the square root of both sides, you have your x minus 3 over 4 to give us what? Plus or minus, okay, because it could be either positive or negative, plus or minus 17 over 16, okay? And we already know that square root, this is equal to the same as saying plus or minus square root of 17 over square root of 16. Okay? And our square root of 16 is 4. So you have plus or minus square root of 17 over 4. Now, the next thing now is to find out what the square root of 17 is. So you have x minus 3 over 4 equals 4.123, plus or minus, all over 4. Okay? So if this moves over to the other side, you have your x to be 3 over 4 plus or minus 4.123 over 4, which gives us 7.123 all over 4, or 3 minus 4.143 is minus 1.123 minus 1.123 over 4. And this will either give us 1.78, this should give us 1.78, or this other one gives us minus 0.28. You can use your calculators to find out if we're correct. So this and this, when plugged into this equation, should give us zero. This expression should give us zero, or approximately zero, just because of the approximation that was done during the square roots. Okay? So let's look at this. Let's try solving this. You have x plus 3 squared equals x plus 7. Now, you can't just use this like this, using this completing squares method. You still have to expand this. And because your x is still here, you need your x to be together. So you have to expand the whole thing and rearrange it. So you have x plus 3 squared. When you expand it, you have x squared plus 6x plus 9 equals x plus 7. So you move everything over and try something. So we can move, okay, let's move x here and move 9 the other side. So you have x squared plus 6x minus 5x, minus x gives us 5x. Then you have equals 7 minus 9, that's minus 2. Okay, so we're ready for completing the squares method. So you try to complete this. Then you have x squared plus 5x plus, you divide this by 2 and square it. When you divide by 2, you have 5 over 2. And when you square it, you have 25 over 4. And so you have equals minus 2 plus 25 over 4. So we factorize this. And when we do that, we have x plus 5 over 2 squared equals 4. Okay? 4 times 2 minus 8. You have minus 8 plus 25 gives us 17. Okay? So this equals this. So try to find the square root of both sides. You have x plus 5 over 2 equals plus or minus square root of 17 over 4, which equals plus or minus root 17 over 2. Okay, so we now have our x to be equal to, this moves over, I have minus 5 over 2 plus or minus root 17 over 2. So when you use your calculator to solve this problem, you find out that your x equals minus 0.438 and x equals minus 4.562. When x is this and this, this condition is satisfied. I hope you found this video useful. As usual, try and solve as many questions as possible. If you have any questions, any topics you'd like us to discuss, feel free to use the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.